What we do expect is that you stay true to your values, that you stop enabling those corrupt and abusive officials and oligarchs who want to steal from our people in Russia and then come and enjoy their loot in European Union countries by spending their holidays, sending their wives and their mistresses on shopping trips, buying up yachts and real estate properties and so on and so forth. This has been happening for far too long. It is heartening to see the European Commission finally moving ahead with enacting the Magnitsky-style mechanism for targeted sanctions on corrupt officials and human rights abusers. And I want to take this opportunity to thank members of the European Parliament from all main political groups who have pushed for years to make this happen. It is time to stop this hypocrisy whereby the people who abuse and attack and undermine the most basic norms of democracy and the rule of law in our country then come to the EU and enjoy the benefits and the privileges and the opportunities that the same norms of democracy and rule of law in the EU. It is time to stop this hypocrisy. It is time to stop this enabling. And it's very heartening to see the Magnitsky mechanism finally moving forward in the European Union. It is also important that the European Union does not accept or legitimize the illegitimate power grab that Mr. Putin is trying to achieve with his constitutional amendments passed this past summer under the cover of the pandemic, including the amendment that would allow him to violate presidential term limits. These amendments were enacted unlawfully, in violation of Russian legislative procedures, and in a sham plebiscite that flunked the most basic norms of Russian electoral legislation and of our commitments under the OSCE. Indeed, you in the European Parliament said it most clearly when you stated in Resolution 2020-277 RSP passed on the 17th of September, it's the same resolution that talks about the poisoning of Alexei Navalny, and it also states that the recent amendments to the Russian Constitution have been, and I quote, illegally enacted and are incompatible with international standards, end of quote. If Mr. Putin attempts to cling to power beyond 2024 in violation of the constitutional term limits, he will become as illegitimate as other dictators who have tried this trick before, from Hugo Chavez to Alexander Lukashenko. And the European Union should respond accordingly with a clear policy of non-recognition. This month, we are marking the 30th anniversary of the OSCE Charter of Paris for a new Europe. In that document, nations spanning from Vancouver to Vladivostok have pledged to foster relations founded on respect and cooperation and declared respect for human rights and fundamental freedoms to be irrevocable. Both of these promises are still not fulfilled. I hope and trust that one day they will be. And I think it's in the interests of all of us on the European continent, you and the European Union, and us in Russia, to work together to try to bring that day a little bit closer. I thank you very much once again for the opportunity to participate, and I look forward to any questions or comments from members of the committee.